Hey, Waubonsie Valley High School. This is Principal Jason Stipp, and welcome to my weekly podcast where I called On Three, where I have students come in and we talk about different activities and athletics and things going on at Waubonsie, and just talk about the day in life as a Waubonsie student. So, and this week I'm excited because I have members in our musical program, because we are talking right now in regard to November 30th. We are talking Prism. So let me introduce who we have here. Why don't we go around the room, check ourselves in. Alexis, we'll start with you. Say your name, your year, and then what area of music you're involved in.
All right, so I'm Alexis Ahlert. I am a senior, and I am in band. I play the alto saxophone.
Oh, nice. So you play the sax.
Yes.
But the alto sax, right? So it's a little different? Was it a little deeper or something?
No, the alto saxophone is just the normal one.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Oh, I just shorten it for saxophone to make it easier. Mm-hmm. Okay. What's the abnormal one?
You have like tenor and barry.
Oh, but I think yours is better, right?
Yeah, I like to think so.
All right, Hannah, go ahead.
I'm Hannah Campbell. I'm a senior, and I'm in chamber orchestra, and I play the violin.
All right, Hannah, welcome. Trent?
I'm Trent. I'm a senior also, and I do like choir and a little bit of the technical stuff.
Oh, so are you doing for Prism? Are you doing behind-the-scenes stuff and singing?
Yeah, a little bit. I'm involved in so much that I can't do much during the show.
I was going to say, but it'd be hard, right?
Yeah, I usually help with setup, so I was here on Monday, late, programming all the light cues, so
because that's your thing. You're one of our paid odd staff people, right?
Not quite yet, but hopefully soon.
So. All right, yeah, because I always see you in a coat walking around the auditorium, right?
Yep.
But you're also on stage all the time, so it's hard to do both, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so welcome to On Three, and as I forgot to mention, appreciate our sponsor, JimmyFinance.com, sponsored here, so I got to give them a little shout out, but we're ready for Prism, so let's talk about this. Tonight's a big night. Hannah, what is tonight? You go through the whole thing, or everything should be coming together, right?
Yeah, so tonight is our big dress rehearsal to prepare for the shows we have on Friday and Saturday. So all of the music students and all of the teachers involved in Prism, we meet in the auditorium at like 6, and we get to watch the Prism video that plays before each of the shows,
oh,
which
God.
Is really it's really fun.
I've seen it.
I heard you're involved.
I am involved. And it's a little cringy because I don't like to really watch myself, oddly enough, but I think it plays out okay. So
excited.
You see it first, huh?
Yeah, we all see it.
That's fun. Nice. Uh-huh. Before or after?
Before.
Okay.
Yeah, we all meet in the auditorium, we watch the video, and then we usually do Christmas festival first, like a couple times.
What time will that be? Around 6:30 then?
Probably.
Okay.
Yeah. And that's like everyone is in that. So yeah, it's kind of chaotic.
So you start with the end. Mm-hmm. For tonight, okay.
Yes, and then we do the whole thing.
Okay, and then everybody sees everything. Mm-hmm. Alexis, a little controversy every year. I see you have a different Prism shirt on than Hannah and Trent. So which is it? Is it this year's? Is it last year's? What are we doing here?
I'm wearing this year's right now, but I heard that today everybody wears this year's. At least all the band kids are wearing this year's shirts.
It's like a band versus orchestra, right?
No one's on the same page about it.
Yeah.
I have just done like... I started on Monday. I wore the 2019, and then I've just gone up from there. So I don't know. I thought we would all wear the this year's tomorrow, because tomorrow's actually Prism.
I asked Mr. Duker for an explanation. He told me that because tomorrow's supposed to be like formal and everything, so it's the last one today. But I would think you would wear the new one on the day it's supposed to happen, right?
Yeah. That makes sense. Yeah.
Makes sense to me.
Pressure, right, Trent? Because you have to keep these shirts all these years, huh?
Yeah.
You have all four, obviously.
No, actually, I didn't. Okay. I didn't get the one freshman year because you know it was online.
Yeah,
oh,
I got
God.
The shirt.
I just Prism got PTSD. Still they sold a shirt for that year?
Yeah, they did.
They did.
A YouTube logo on it.
It's connected by music.
Yes, I do remember that. Okay, because I forgot, because your first year, that's how we did business.
Yeah.
What a mess. Because you came back in January, some of you came back in January, but Prism was still online.
Yeah.
Okay. Trenton, what do you love about, what connects you to this performance coming up this weekend?
I mean, I think the thing I love so much about Prism is it's a great opportunity for everyone to hear everyone else, mm-hmm. you know, with like, especially in some of the top choirs I know, and I assume in some of the top bands and orchestras, we have concert reviews that you have to do, mm-hmm. where you have to go enjoy, you know, like other music and kind of talk about, you know, the different like things of music, mm-hmm. and that's part of musicianship. And I think it's a really great opportunity at Prism where you get to hear everyone, you get to hear, you know, even some of the smallest, like small groups. We have mm-hmm. audition people just of a couple of people, like a string quartet or whatever, but then you also have your big groups like show choir, right, your jazz bands, mm-hmm. all of that. And so I think it's a great opportunity for, you know, everyone to hear everyone else, because we're so busy and hectic with our schedules where it's like, you know, we have our concerts this week and band has them next week or whatever, so
to bring
it's like
it all together,
you're too busy to, you know, make it out to everything. So I think it's a great opportunity, you know, especially tonight where, you know, there's not a lot of pressure. You can just kind of sit and enjoy everyone else's music and, you know, especially coming together at the end for Christmas festival and make music together.
Alexis, what's the hottest game in the warm-up rooms to play?
Like board game
one? Yeah, like what are you playing?
I always bring Uno.
And you're an Uno, so many you're people, an Uno person. Uno,
yeah.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
I mean, when I go in there, there's like a ton of games going, yes, right? Yeah. Card mm-hmm. games. Hannah, you a game player or you just get in the zone?
No, I wouldn't know because I do Mission Impossible, which is like the backstage
crew. Oh, so you
crew.
Two are involved while you're playing.
Differently, but yes, yeah. yes. Okay. Both like behind the scenes. But yeah, since sophomore year, I've never been like in the homerooms. I'm always backstage, like setting up all the chairs and stands and
while
the choral
in
risers.
Performance attire.
Yeah, but it's actually really nice because you get to hear all the music because you're like right there backstage. Mm-hmm. So I feel like when you're in the homerooms, you kind of miss out mm-hmm. on hearing everything because it's like loud and chaotic, which is fun in its own right. But I also really like hearing all of the pieces and yeah. being like right there and getting to, you know, congratulate everyone as they walk off stage. It's yeah. really rewarding.
Quite the feeling, right?
Yeah.
Trenton, you homeroom game player or you're behind
yeah,
the scenes?
Yeah. yeah. Last year, it was a lot of Go Fish, a lot
okay.
of Go Fish.
Okay, all right.
But
because after four times, you're just yeah. like, you know, it gets a little until that last one, mm-hmm. right?
Yeah,
right.
yeah.
So, yeah.
But this year, I learned to play euchre with my friends when playing it
I
at
gotta
lunch.
I got to get in there.
So
what lunch period you got?
Fifth period. Yeah,
really?
Yeah.
You need a fourth person sometimes?
Maybe. Yeah,
I will definitely get in on that game.
All right.
Fifth period, where are you playing?
Out in the option area.
I know,
yeah.
option area. Where
yeah.
do you sit?
Like right by the vending machines.
Oh, I've seen you
yeah.
there. Yeah, yeah,
yeah.
I'll join in that game. I'm a very good euchre player.
Oh,
okay.
okay.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, I love that game. All right, so last show, Hannah, just what are you, as a senior, as your last time, what are some takeaways this time of year, moving on as you get older, you'll look back on this and think what?
I'll just like think of like how much fun it was because I love being involved in music. I mean, I have been since sixth grade and I'm just like so glad to be a part of like such an amazing music program, mm-hmm. like one of the best in the area. And it's just like so much fun to be able to see like everyone's hard work and my own hard work pay off. And I just love that like it's such like a big part of the community too. Like so many people come to watch Prism. So I mean, I think looking back, I'll just be like super grateful to have experienced something like this in high school because, you know, like a lot of schools don't even like have a music program or like, you know, they don't have an orchestra or just have a band. So I'm just like really grateful that, you know, we are able to do this. It's really fun.
Alexis, what are some of your memories from Prism and what will you look back on most fondly?
The moment you have to like get on the stage quietly mm-hmm. and when the curtains like are shut and you're just sitting there in the darkness just waiting mm. for them to open, it's like it's the best feeling ever. It's just because like, everyone's sitting there and you can feel everyone being like scared
yeah.
and then the curtains open and then you can see like the stage, I mean not the stage, all the audience full, and it's just like that one second. I would do it every year just to have that moment, like feeling right there.
What's the you have family coming to watch or
yes yeah. my grandma from New York is coming
oh
in,
wow
so
has
really
she ever
exciting.
Seen it before?
No.
Oh,
first timer. Yeah.
I'm getting emotional here thinking about this.
Yeah.
So great. Will she see all four or
no? She's just coming to Saturdays.
Okay.
Yeah.
Which the 6 o'clock or
6 o'clock,
okay
yeah.
that's mm-hmm. what I'm gonna be at. So I love the fact that what a gift to the community, right? This, mm-hmm. this, you know, free, quote unquote free. It is free. So I don't know why I said quote unquote, but just this like gift of music and this, your time. Thank you. Because it's a Friday, Saturday, but I also know it's tonight with dress rehearsal. I know it's the whole week you've been working. You've been putting these together for Trenton. Talk about that. Like this is, I mean, how long have you been working? Do you have any side pieces?
You mean groups?
Yeah.
I mean,
how long have you been working on those pieces?
Or I mean, for some of these groups from like the start of the year, like yeah. I'm pretty sure it was our second rehearsal of her show choir when we like first took a look at our Prism yeah. piece, just to, you know, get a little bit of it, you know, in our brains. But also, you know, with like Mosaic Ensemble, mm-hmm. right? We've been working on Butterfly for a long time. There, you know, all these groups that I'm in. It's been a long process coming, and it especially this week, you know, it's kind of like the final push, and it's nice to see it all sort of yeah. come together, right?
Yeah. So, yeah, I can't imagine just to see there, and then to the end to watch everybody kind of just be a part of singing together mm-hmm. and. The last couple, obviously the what's the finale called?
Christmas
yeah. Festival is always, you know, one of everybody's favorites where everyone's kind of singing and celebrating, just being together, you know, as people. So, all right. So Prism, tomorrow on Friday, 6 o'clock and 7:30, right? No,
8:15.
Thank
yes.
you. Okay. That's important for me. Okay. 6 o'clock and 8:15 to get everybody out. And then Saturday, the same thing. Saturday, any, you have any little routines that, after all this is over, like sometimes a play will get together and they'll go out for pancakes or whatever. But like, is there any after show routines, Hannah, that you do?
Yeah. I know last year, me and a bunch of other orchestra kids, we went to Rosati's and it was late. It was like 10 or 11, but we just like ordered a bunch of pizzas. And I think we played like Mafia at the table or something okay. like that. Like, I don't know. It was just really fun, like, to be able to, you know, like, connect. And a lot of those people were seniors. So, you know, it was like a fun, like, last little thing, you know, to
sure.
do to right. celebrate Prism and just hang out.
Trent, for you, do you have a routine after Prism routine?
I mean, obviously, a lot of people go out and take photos out yeah. by some of the Christmas trees and decorations yeah. we have set up. And then obviously everyone taking apart.
Yeah, because you're behind all that stuff.
Oh, yeah. And I mean, with Trium taking down all the decorations,
yeah.
but
so really,
you know,
busy.
The stuff that goes yeah. into like putting up the star curtain yeah. and the wreath and.
Alexis, for you or do you?
I usually get ice cream.
Oh, nice. There you go. After
a
concert,
while,
right?
Yeah, yeah. It gets a little bit of a headache. There's a lot of people, and then ice cream feels really good afterwards.
Yeah. What's your go to?
A hot fudge sundae from McDonald's.
Sure. You're a McDonald's girl. All right. It's simple and easy, right?
Yeah,
you don't have to wait in line.
Yeah.
And it's got the hot fudge on it with that soft serve ice cream.
Perfect.
I like that. Yeah. But you have nuts put on or not?
No.
Just the hot fudge. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Okay. I like that. Not the caramel. I like the fudge there. They do a good sundae.
Yeah. Yeah. It's really underrated.
Yeah.
I like it.
I agree. All right. So tell me. I'm going to put you on the spot here. Any directors completely have a meltdown this week? Who's like, oh my God, I just got to survive. We're going to be fine, but a complete meltdown. Anybody having a meltdown, Hannah?
I don't think so.
Okay,
I don't know.
Good.
I think Mr. Veter is a little stressed out just because
it's his first year.
Yeah, it's
he
his first
know.
Year, so I can't hold
I
that
can't
against him.
I can't picture him stressed.
No,
but,
he doesn't have like, I don't think anyone's had a breakdown, or if they do, we don't know about it. They're keeping
that's
it down
good,
low,
right?
Under wraps, mm. but I don't know. I mean, I think everyone holds it together pretty well. I mean, it's like organized chaos,
yeah.
so.
Alexis, what's the one thing that's like, oh God, here we go. Every year it's like this, and. There's none of those moments, huh?
Not usually, you know. Just like okay. like the time the fourth time comes around, I'm like, oh my God, one more time.
Here
like
we
a
go.
Little bit, gets
yeah.
a little bit at the end.
And then you start realizing it's the end, so you're
yeah.
like, okay, we got this,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Trent, for you, you kind of know that because I always feel like there's a moment on stage where you have to have this like, nobody knows their lines, get it together.
Mm-hmm.
And then you know
yeah.
what? And then people are like, okay, well, I mean, anybody have that moment in Prism or it's a whole different show?
I mean, yeah, I feel like especially tonight, it just kind of clicks
yeah.
because, you know, this week we've been.
Calvert seems steady up there too. I would think he
yeah,
would kind
yeah.
of, you
I
know,
mean,
but he's kind of more backstage, I
yeah,
guess.
Yeah, and I think it's a great experience for him. And I mean, he's been doing it for so long. Yeah. And actually, it's something to note, too, is he was one of the people who started Prism here, this tradition, and this is his last year.
Yeah.
So,
it's a
unique experience for him.
To see it from the start and then to be
to
here 34 years later. All right. So at this point, first of all, thank you for coming on. Like I said, my show is sponsored by JimmyFinance.com. If you know anyone that's looking for a mortgage and they're a first-time mortgage person, reach out to JimmyFinance.com because he is sponsoring my podcast so that you three all get a $5 gift card to Dunkin' Donuts for being a guest, if you want to pass that down for me.
Thank you
for taking your time and joining me. And then like what I like to do is how I typically end the show is just you giving a chance to give a shout out to somebody in your life that's just been a big supporter of you or somebody, whether it be a parent, a director, a teacher, a friend, just somebody that you maybe want to say, hey, this person has just been somebody that has really helped through this moment. Maybe even somebody in your musical career that has kind of helped with you. So you, let's start with you, Alexis. Anybody you want to kind of give a special shout out to, or who would you like to just say thanks to?
Definitely my band director. Oh, all of them, but especially Mr. Dendelis. He usually keeps me calm. I get nervous.
He's got that. Yeah. I can see him being a calming presence.
Like,
yeah.
Oh, breathe, and it's just everything's fine afterwards.
Which is weird for a percussion person. I would think they'd be a little more high.
Hitting the drums.
Yeah, right.
He's very chill. And he always just makes me happy when I'm sad and stuff. And he's really been
awesome.
The best.
Cool. Yeah.
You kind of stole my answer. I was going to say him too.
Oh, just nice. How is that connection?
Just because I've worked with him for Mission Impossible for the past, this is like my third year. So
how did he get that label? Because that's his thing, right?
Yeah, I don't know.
He's just always in charge of behind the scenes with Prism?
I think this is 21st year doing Mission Impossible, but it's been like 30-something years of Prism. So he's been doing it for a really long time.
Where does it get the name just because it's such an impossible mission?
It's not impossible.
Right.
But it's just, I don't know. It just makes it fun.
Yeah,
because
you're moving so much, right? You're all the sets and all that, right?
Yeah, but he's just like does so much for Prism that like a lot of people don't even like realize like what goes on backstage because you don't see it. That's like part of the magic of it. So, Prism would not function the way it does without, Mr. Dandelis and all the Mission Impossible people. So,
awesome.
Yeah.
Perfect.
In kind of a similar vein, I just want to shout out Mr. Calvert again. Yeah. He's been a great mentor for me these like past 4 years. I'm going into theater now into college too. So
good for you, man.
Kind of following in those footsteps and,
you play a good King Henry.
And I mean, it's just that, I feel like he puts so much into it and it's a great opportunity to, just like flex his technical skills. Yeah. I mean, a lot of people don't necessarily realize how much we change for Prism, right? We're changing all the lights. We have to put a wreath up there. We have to, move some of our sound baffles down to get that curtain up there. And so, I think he has been able to, do all these things for Prism over all these years. And, I'm not sure he always gets the recognition he deserves for that. Just a shout out to him because he's always sitting up there in the booth and he's always made it work. So.
Awesome. Well, I'm excited for the show. Thank you for giving your time. Like I said, it's a precious resource. You all are being pulled in so many different directions. And for you to give your time to share music for the community, I see it and I appreciate it. So thank you. If you're listening and it's before Friday or Saturday and you have a friend or a relative, come see the show. It's amazing to watch young adults do their thing. And I'm looking forward to seeing it again every year, year 13 for me, and I can't wait to see it. So good luck. I'll see you all Saturday. Good luck tonight. I'm going to try to pop in there tonight because I like the rehearsal night too. Hopefully the video plays out okay. Okay? So come watch Prism next week. I think we're going to do our dance team members as they get ready to host our first big invite. And then we'll see where we go from there. But thank you for listening. Come out and see Prism and break it out with me. Warriors on three. 1, 2, 3.
Warriors.
All right. Thank you, everybody. See you in the halls.